J-Ray 501 here. I want to tell you a story that I had completely forgotten about until today. And I hope I never really forget it completely. It's a story of a man with no arms. So I went on vacation to Cape Cod. And I decided, me and my friend decided to go over to Martha's Vineyard. So we get on the boat, and we see this very good-looking man with a beautiful wife, and he had no arms. And you know that feeling when you see somebody that's handicapped or, you know, that has problems or issues? You immediately get that gut-wrenching feeling that, oh my God, wonder if he was born that way. I wonder what happened. There was something amazing about this man. Everyone on the boat said hi to him. He was extremely friendly and vivacious. Like, having no arms, maybe he really had them. You know what I mean? It was like he had arms, like he was just a regular person. And I saw other people kind of look and try not to stare. And, you know, you could tell everyone around was pretty much affected. So we got off the boat. We were waiting for the tour bus and happened to sit down next to this couple. And while waiting for the bus, we got to talking, and finally the bus never came. So since we were kind of talking, we said, oh yeah, you guys want to go get some lunch? And we went shopping together. And while we sat and had lunch, he started talking about what had happened to him. Now, mind you, this man at one point in his life was a very high-powered businessman. And he lost everything and started over. Became an electrician. So he was up on a box, one of those boxes that lifts you up for the high tension power lines or some kind of electrical equipment that he needed to work on. And he was standing in the box, and all of a sudden it touched a wire. The box touched a wire, and the box got hot, and the electrocution went in one hand and through his body and out the other hand. And he basically died right then and there. They brought him back to life several times. And they said to his wife, his arms are literally burnt off. In order to save his life, we need to take off his arms. And she said, you do whatever you have to do. I want my husband. So they took off amputated both arms. And he opened up his shirt, pulled down his shirt, she pulled down his shirt and showed us. He was a Christian and he had on a metal cross that day. And that metal cross saved his life. And it also made a permanent scar of a cross on his chest, because when the electricity shot through his body, it jumped away from the heart and went into the metal cross and then jumped back out. Otherwise, it would have fried his heart completely and he would have been dead. The story was amazing. And he severely handicapped. He can't do really much of anything without other people helping him. But his sense of humor, he said it forever changed his life. He was, he worked really a lot and, was trying to get back on his feet with the new job. And, he realized in that moment when he came back to life that nothing really matters, not money, not power, not public recognition, not a high-profile job. Nothing mattered except his family. That was the only thing that mattered to him. And he was so humble, and then he would just turn around and start making jokes again. And I was almost in tears because, I go through all sorts of emotions on a daily basis. Sometimes I don't feel like I get enough coffee. Sometimes I feel like I don't get enough sleep. Sometimes, I have issues on my job. Sometimes I don't feel like I measure up socially. We all have self-doubts, self-worth issues, pride, ego, sloth, slander. I mean, we're human. But to be around someone who really actually died and came back and lived to tell about it and is forever changed changes everyone around that person. So we had a really nice day with these people. We got back on the boat, and everybody on the boat was chit-chatting with him on the way back, and it was really an amazing experience. And after the excursion, my girlfriend said to me, "That was one of the most incredible days of my life." And I said, "Yeah, I was kind of thinking the same thing, that, I don't know how I can ever be the same after that. It was so humbling." But sure enough, a year later, here I am today, being reminded once again that I forgot. I forgot what my vision really is. And so I just thought I would share that with you. One of the things this gentleman is still a businessman. Obviously he needs help, but he is, we talked about leadership and, being in business for yourself. So I want to just read you this real quick. "The one quality that all leaders have in common is that they have a clear and exciting vision for the future. There is something that only the leader can do. Only the leader can think about the future and plan for the future each day. Excellent leaders take the time to think through and develop a clear picture of where they want the organization to be in 1, 2, and 5 years. Leaders have the ability to communicate this vision in such a way that others buy in and eventually see the vision as belonging to them. It is the vision of the future possibilities of what can be that arouses emotion and motivates people to give of their best. The most powerful vision is always qualitative, aimed at and described in terms of values and mission rather than quantitative, which is described in terms of money and numbers. Of course, money is important, but the decision and commitment to be the best in business is far more exciting. And this is exactly how I have run my business, based on that statement right there. And I pride myself in being a professional at what I do, and I do it good. I don't make money like other people do, but that's okay. My bills are paid. I have beautiful friends, a wonderful family, and for some reason, I keep being reminded with situations and people like this that are put in my life for a reason, for me to learn about who I am and who I want to be. Right? Another key to leadership success is for you to keep your cool. Study at Stanford Business School, examine the qualities that companies look for in promoting young managers towards senior executive positions. The study concluded that the two most important qualities required for great success were, first, the ability to put together and function as part of a team. Since all work is ultimately done by teams and managers, output is the output of the team. The ability to select team members, set objectives, delegate responsibility, and finally, get the job done. The second quality required for rapid promotion was found to be the ability to function under pressure, and especially in a crisis. Keeping your cool in a crisis means to practice patience and self-control under difficult or even disappointing circumstances. The character and quality of a leader is often demonstrated in these critical moments under fire, when everyone is watching, observing, and privately taking notes. As Rudyard Kipling once said, if you can keep your head when all around you are losing theirs and blaming it on you, then the world is yours and all that's in it. God bless. Stay inspired. Give peace. Give love. And let all the rest go. God bless.